Okay, this is Jeff, W6FCC. I'm going to walk through what I had to do to get this NanoVNA set up. First thing you want to do, in my opinion, is to be able to get to this device manager quickly. So I actually created a desktop icon and then dragged it down to my taskbar. And you create a new shortcut, and what you're going to type in there is devmgmt.msc, Microsoft Control Panel. This is in Windows. What this will allow you to do is to immediately get into the device manager, which is very helpful when you're setting up these devices. So let me bring up, I'll go ahead and put this away temporarily, and I'm going to bring up the device manager and let's see what's in it. Here, I'll just slide it over here. So I don't need these other devices. They have nothing to do with it. So what happens when you turn on the VNA is the very first thing Windows is going to do, if it's Windows, is going to go out and try to find a driver for it. And it'll spend some time looking around for drivers. And eventually, you'll see this appear on your screen, ports, COM, and LPT. If it was successful, you're going to have an SDM microelectronics virtual COM port. You can actually go to stm.com and find their device driver, but for my Windows 7 it worked, and Windows 10 apparently you don't need anything else. So this means that we're on COM 3 and that it's working, so I'll put that away for now. Next thing you need to do is to get the DfuSe program that will allow you to actually upgrade the firmware. So you go to this stm.com, and what happens when you go to st.com, not stm, but st.com, first thing it does is it takes you to content, this particular page. Now, I've already created an account. You do want to have an account. So you'll get to this point when you try to grab software. First thing you want to do, though, is you want to do a search. And what you're looking for, I'm going to copy it and paste it in here. You're looking for STSW, that's ST Electronic Software, dash STM32080. When you get this program, STM32080, the first thing you do is you do a search. And what happens when you do the search is it does take some time, and eventually it comes down to the point where it tells you that this is the DfuSe USB device firmware upgrades these devices. So when you click on this part number, you get to another screen, and you can go ahead and say get software. It may ask you to log in and confirm your email address, so you'll have to do that. So you say get software, and now it brings you to this screen. This is the part number you want. So when you say get that software, it's going to send you, hell, you got to accept the license agreement. Okay, got that. And eventually it's going to say, here is a program, and you'll find that I have a thing in here which I'll say, here's, let's say, firmware images. I'll stick it in here because this is a useful place for it. And I'm going to stick this STM. I don't need that because this is the second time I've copied it. But you end up getting this ENSTSW STM32080 zip file. So you save it, and it downloads it, and eventually it gets it. So now let's go to that subdirectory. I'm going to open that folder. And there is the STM software that they're telling us about. When you open this package, what you see are the following programs inside. This is the one you want, DfuSe Demo 3.06. So you can go ahead and I've already got that demo here. But this is the setup version right now. When you run the setup, you'll end up getting the DF set demo as a separate application. So you're going to bring this out here and you're going to run it and it's going to install, and it's all going to end up, turns out, in a nice subdirectory over here. Let me just go to that subdirectory to tell you where it's going to end up being. Eventually, you're going to end up in here. Let's see, bring this up. Eventually, you're going to end up in Programs 86. You go to the S. I'm typing the letter S. You come down here to ST Microelectronics. You look at their software. You look at the DfuSe 3.06. You go look at bin. And there is the program you want to run in order to upgrade the unit. And there is another one here that's of some value, and that's this file manager. When you bring up the file manager, this allows you to create a DFU file from a bin file if you happen to download a thing that has a bin file in it. Right now I don't care about that. Cancel all this. I just want to run the DfuSe demo. Now when you run this, it's available DFU devices, but a device is not available until it's in this DFU mode. You can look up how to put your device in DFU mode, but right now nothing's showing up. But let me go ahead and put my device in DFU mode. I kind of hate to do it, but I'm going to do it anyway, just to show you. So we come over here and it says config, on mine anyway, go into DFU, and I'm going to reset and enter DFU mode. I'm probably going to wish I hadn't done this, but I get into DFU mode and all of a sudden now this appears. I have a device in DFU mode, and I would then go ahead and choose the software that I want to upgrade. Over on this side you can save your own, what's in the unit right now, you can save that, but I don't care about saving this right now. What you would do over here is you choose, and we find a VNU file, and I think the one you want is the standard one. I've put standard font in front of it, but it's NanoVNA H2020 January 18th. This is the one for the large fonts. This is the one that I have on my unit right now. So when you open this, you're ready to go ahead and upgrade the unit. Again, I hate doing this, but if I did the upgrade, it would put this file in the unit. Let's just verify that the file's in there. Let's just see something here. So it's already got this program in there, so I don't want to upload it again. So now that you've done that and you've got the firmware, the DFU file, I don't need this anymore. I don't need this anymore. Put that away. You can leave the DFU mode right now in this unit. It then put my unit back on the screen with the large fonts, the one that I chose, and now I'm ready to run some software on it. And you do want to calibrate it. No, I don't care about that now. You do want to calibrate your unit, but let me go over here and go into the NanoVNA, and I'm going to do the measurements here. Let's see what I come up with. Display software. One of the display softwares I like is this NanoVNA EXE. Bring that up. That's one of the ones that I used. And you say connect to the unit. And then you can do, I had an antenna connected to it, but I don't right now. And that's where I did these plots. I changed the maximum down to 2. I came down here and chose that I wanted to look at SWR. This S11, S21, all that stuff, this simply means that it's connected to the port 1 as opposed to port 2, and it's getting information. This one is both a transmit and receive, so that's going to give you your reflected power back. if you're testing a device, you're going to go out one and into the other. Anyway, that's how you do it, and hopefully that will help. The NanoVNA Saver software is also really good. It's quite a bit bigger on your screen, and it will show you four plots simultaneously. You can learn about that on your own. So the key was you put the unit in DFU mode, make sure that it shows up in the device manager. Then you go and run the DfuSe, the program that will actually program it, and DfuSe demo version 3.06, and upload your software. Then you turn the unit off, turn it back on again. Now you have to calibrate it. Okay, good luck. Have fun.